All right, guys, welcome back to CES. We're finally here at the Nvidia booth with Julian. We've never been in a frame together.
We're finally in a frame.
So there's a lot of stuff here. Do you want to split this up?
Or? We'll divvy it up. Dibs on VR.
Well, we only have one mic, so.
We're going to start in the Geforce section, and this is a pretty big part of the booth. So I brought Roger along, and we're going to do a bit of a lightning round, starting with HDR G-Sync monitors. What do we have over there?
We have a monitor that makes great gaming even greater. The HDR actually makes the colors more vibrant and gives the scene a lot more life.
Yeah, we have two side by side, the standard dynamic range and the high dynamic range. And honestly, the standard dynamic range, I thought there was like a light on it washing it out, but it's just the high dynamic range is so much darker and more rich. I actually have that SDR monitor at home, and now I can't look. I just got it, and now it's like inadequate. So thank you, CES, for that. Moving on, we have GeForce Now over here behind us, and they're running games on Macs and lower end PCs without discrete graphics cards. Explain this witchcraft.
GeForce Now allows Mac users to get the latest games on their Mac. As long as they have a good network connection, they can just open an app and get the latest and best games.
Access to a GTX 1080 in the cloud right now for free in open beta when it opens up, so that's pretty exciting. And then finally over there, we have GeForce Experience's Facebook Live announcement. And what does that mean for GeForce Experience?
So live streaming gameplay has grown exponentially within the past few years, and this is actually a great tool for a lot of our NVIDIA gamers. They can just, right within GeForce Experience, they can quickly hit a couple buttons and then quickly live stream onto Facebook, and their friends can just quickly watch and comment or share whatever opinions.
So if you want to go on Facebook Live and stream something more interesting than you eating a burrito, now that's possible. So that's the GeForce section. We're going to move on.
So as you guys heard, we announced the brand new Nvidia Shield. This is the first time I'm seeing it in the flesh, but Mike, you've been here all day showing it to people. Why don't you tell us what we're seeing here in the booth?
So you're going to see a lot of gaming. So we have 4K HDR gaming. We announced Smart Home. So Google Assistant is going to be coming to Shield. Talk to your Shield and activate your coffee maker or turn on a camera in your baby's room. And we also announced Amazon coming to Shield. So that was a big thing. One other thing with gaming is that GeForce Now has Pascal GPUs behind it, and that's a big thing because we're able to bring awesome titles like the Ubisoft games coming to GeForce Now. So inside of Shield, you have the X1 chip, which is powering all this hardware. Someone has a PC in their office and they have a Shield in their living room, and they don't want to pull their PC out into their living room to play there, they can cast that over to their Shield and not have to leave. So that's essentially what's happening here.
What about to the device itself? Are there any new changes that people should look out for?
A couple things. So we have a new controller. It's really sleek, and it feels really good in your hand. It also has always-on assistance, so when Google Assistant does come to your Shield, you'll be able to prompt it for requests and questions, etc. You also get a remote that comes with Shield, so that was something that people have been asking for.
All right, well, thank you.
Now, of course, it wouldn't be an NVIDIA booth if we didn't bring some VR to share with everyone. We've got a couple new games to show off, including Rock Band and Robo Recall. Why did we bring VR to CES?
Well, VR is like the latest and greatest gaming technology. It's the future of gaming as well. And we want to bring it here to show people what the best VR experience is like.
So NVIDIA is really going in on self-driving cars this year, as we heard in the keynote last night. Sri, tell us what we're seeing behind us here.
Well, we have displayed a Model S from Tesla, and this is being driven by our autonomous car computer, Drive PX2. It's one of the production vehicles today that's doing autonomous driving. You don't have to wait for 5 years. It's there today.
So these are actually on the roads.
Oh, yeah, it's rolled out. It's actually Danny's car.
It's whose car?
Danny Shapiro's car.
Okay, so note to self, don't scratch it.
Drive PX2 is being taken to production with one of our major tier one partners, auto supplier ZF. There's an engagement with Bosch to do the same. And Audi is going to be building the next generation autonomous cars using Drive PX platform. So all this pretty cool stuff is happening. And the biggest showpiece was the demo that Jensen showed last night. It's basically our BB-8 car, which has evolved into a car that can actually take a person from place A to place B, point A to point B, just by verbal command. You can say, hey, autopilot engage, and the car engages, takes you from point A to point B. At the moment when the car knows it's reached its limits, it'll say, I'm disengaging, driver take over.
So that is what NVIDIA has brought to CES. Favorite part of it?
I gotta say, I'm feeling that Tesla with the Nvidia brain. Do you think Danny would let me borrow it, maybe?
No, but if it just drives off on its own.
No one will be the
wiser. There's a lot here to see. I love the HDR monitors, but obviously Nvidia's brought all the guns out here for CES, showing off all aspects the company does. And it's cool to just get to play around with it. So thank you guys for watching. Sad you couldn't join us here. But keep watching more Nvidia GeForce. We're going to be covering all of CES. Stay tuned.